From Tampa Bay streaming news leader, this is ABC Action News.
Changes on the way as we head into the weekend with your weather. Greg D will have that for you in a moment. Good morning, I'm James Tully. Here are your ABC Action News headlines on this Friday morning. First up, a death investigation in Pinellas County. Deputies found a man's lifeless body floating in the Bocasiega Bay. They confirmed his identity late last night. The Pinellas County Sheriff's Office says the victim was last seen getting into a small boat after visiting with friends Wednesday night. Deputies think that his boat capsized, sending him overboard. Today, you are invited to join hundreds of people who will come together to remember a St. Pete veterinarian and his wife. Dr. Harvey Partridge and his wife Patricia died when their small plane crashed while trying to land at a North Carolina airport last month. Today's ceremony of life will begin at 2 o'clock at Seabreeze Park in Terracea. There are new twists this morning as law enforcement across Florida search for a missing 5-year-old. Now deputies think that Taylor Williams could have been missing for weeks, if not months. Authorities trying to piece together a timeline with the public's help because they say Williams' mother, Brianna, is not cooperating with detectives. We've now learned that deputies say little Taylor did not walk out of her Jacksonville home on her own. They are not calling the mother a suspect or person of interest at this time. A Lakeland canine officer has been fired after deputies arrested him for DUI. We've told you how an arrest report found Officer Chad Landry was going 18 miles over the speed limit and swerving in his lane, his arrest happening while he was in the panhandle for a dog competition. The Lakeland Police Department found Landry violated their conduct standards and was terminated. In sports, the Lightning are in Sweden for the NHL's Global Series. The Bolts will take on the Buffalo Sabres at 2 o'clock this afternoon, the first of two games being held in Stockholm. The Lightning are inviting you to a watch party for tomorrow's game. You'll be able to hang out with Thunderbug, win some great Lightning swag. The party kicks off at noon at Armature Works in Tampa. The puck drops at 1 o'clock. And today, you don't have to catch a flight to Athens to get great baklavas or gyros. The 39th annual Tampa Greek Food Festival begins at noon at St. John Greek Orthodox Church on Swan. And besides the tasty Greek food, there'll also be some live music, Greek dancers, and arts and crafts. The festival runs through Sunday. Opa, Greg.
Opa, yeah.
We love the baklava, but we're convinced that it's the stickiest, messiest dessert you can possibly enjoy.
Wonderfully messy. Gets all over the place, especially if the kids are eating it, if you're heading out there today or the weekend. It looks really good. Now, today, temperatures in the 80s midday, but then that temperature starts falling in the afternoon as a cold front approaches the region. And with that front, there will be a chance for a couple of showers later in the day. And then you're really going to see the wind pick up. Notice the wind all day going up until it gets to about 10 miles per hour by 4 o'clock in the afternoon. That sets us up for big changes for the weekend. Cloudy early Saturday, 75, maybe some drizzle. Perfect day on Sunday with temperatures in the upper 70s. You can always get that latest forecast on the ABC Action News app.